Good evening, and welcome to the Church of St. Mary. We welcome all visitors and members of our area faith community to this evening's celebration of the liturgy, and in a special way, we welcome Father Jack Nordic, who will be presiding with us this evening. God has gathered us together to renew our efforts in sharing the life of Christ and being the love of Christ. So let us stand and greet the presence of Christ that we find in one another. Let us join together in singing our gathering song, number 310, in the Maroon Pew Hymnal, or on the screens in front of you, number 310, Table of Plenty.
Come to the feast of heaven and earth. Come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty. Oh, come and sit at my table, where saints and sinners are friends. I wait to welcome the lost and lonely to share the cup of my love. Come to the feast of heaven and earth. Come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty. Oh, come and eat without money. Come to drink without price. My feast of gladness will feed your spirit with faith and fullness of life.
Come to the feast of heaven and earth. Come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty.
My bread will ever sustain you
through days of sorrow and woe.
My
wine will flow like a sea of gladness to flood the depths of your soul.
Come to the feast of heaven and earth.
Come to the table of plenty.
God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. People have been saying, why doesn't he use the railing? Well, duh, I'm male and I'm German. But it makes me wonder, how in the old days did ladies get by with hoop skirts and bustles? You know, I keep stepping on this dumb thing. So when you had that, that had to have been a real problem. Can you imagine? Just think this last week. Working out in the garden with the things that people wore in the 19th century. You know, there are things we can be thankful for a lot that has changed. So we gather together to give God glory, praise, and honor, to ask for his kindness and blessings, and to pray that he would watch over, guide us, and protect us in all that we do. And so as we prepare to celebrate this Mass, let us acknowledge our sins so that we might better prepare to celebrate these mysteries. Lord Jesus, you open for us the way to heaven. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, with great kindness and love, you show us the way to follow. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are seated at the Father's right hand to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And we sing glory to God.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
We praise you, we bless you,
we adore you,
we glorify you,
we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
You take away the sins of the world,
receive our bread.
You are seated at the right hand
of the Father.
Let us pray. Lord God, we pray that you would show favor to your people and mercifully grant to us the gifts of your grace, so that made strong in faith, hope, and charity, we would ever be watchful in your commands. Grant in abundance your mercy to us, and so that with you as our ruler and guide, we would use the good things that pass our way now in a way that we might hold fast to those things which will last forever. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord appeared to Abraham by the terebinth of Mamre as he sat in the entrance of the tent while the day was growing hot. Looking up, Abraham saw three men standing nearby. When he saw them, he ran from the entrance of the tent to greet them, and bowing to the ground, he said, "Sir, if I may ask you this favor, please do not go on past your servant. Let some water be brought that you may bathe your feet, and then rest yourselves under the tree. Now that you have come this close to your servant, let me bring you a little food that you may refresh yourselves. And afterward, you may go on your way." The men replied, "Very well. Do as you have said." Abraham hastened into the tent and told Sarah, "Quick, 3 measures of fine flour. Knead it and make rolls." He ran to the herd, picked out a tender, choice steer, and gave it to a servant who quickly prepared it. Then Abraham got some curds and milk, as well as the steer that had been prepared, and set these before the 3 men. And he waited on them under the tree while they ate. They asked Abraham, "Where is your wife Sarah?" He replied, "There in the tent." One of them said, "I will surely return to you about this time next year, and Sarah will have a son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Justice will live in the presence of the Lord. They who do justice will live in the presence of the Lord. Whoever walks without fault, who does what is just, and speaks the truth from their heart. Whoever does not slander with their tongue. They who do justice will live in the presence of the Lord. Who does no wrong to a neighbor, who casts no slur on a friend, who looks with scorn on the wicked, such honor those who fear the Lord. They who do justice will live in the presence of the Lord. Who lends no money at interest and accepts no bribes against the innocent, such a one shall never be shaken, such a one shall never be shaken. They who do justice will live in the presence of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, now I rejoice in my sufferings for your sake, and in my flesh I am filling up what is lacking in the afflictions of Christ on behalf of his body, which is the church, of which I am a minister, in accordance with God's stewardship given to me, to bring to completion for you the word of God, the mystery hidden from ages and from generations past. But now it has been manifested to his holy ones, to whom God chose to make known the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles. It is Christ in you, the hope for glory. It is he whom we proclaim, admonishing everyone and teaching everyone with all wisdom, that we may present everyone perfect in Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Speak, Lord, your servant is listening. Have the words of everlasting life. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus entered a village where a woman whose name was Martha welcomed him. She had a sister named Mary who sat beside the Lord at his feet listening to him speak. Martha, burdened with much serving, came to him and said, "Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me by myself to do the serving? Tell her to help me." The Lord said to her in reply, "Martha, Martha, you are anxious and worried about many things, but there is need of only one. Mary has chosen the better part, and it will not be taken from her." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Well, I think Abraham might have been from Minnesota. Just think about it. These three strangers come to his house asking for directions. Of course, they were not German, because they were asking for directions. And, they talk a little bit, and then they say, "Well, we got to go." And Abraham said, No. Can't you stay for a little lunch?" And so what did they do? She starts making bread dough, and he goes out and picks a steer that they butcher and bake, roast, cook something, grill. So how long do you think that took? I figure about 5 hours after they said, "We have to go," they were still saying goodbye and still, finishing up the things. But that's where the strangers reveal their message, which is that Sarah will bear a child, which is the beginning of this whole sphere of Israel. So now during that time, they weren't just sitting staring at the television set. They were talking. And this is all about the sense of hospitality, which for those people was just really critical. It was a pillar of social order. Whenever you could, you showed hospitality, not only to your family and friends, but to strangers and even to enemies. If someone came to you for shelter, you provided it. And that was the hard, fast rule that someone who was a guest was always safe in your house. And part of the hospitality is, we know that if you're Norwegian or German or whatever, every culture uses food as a part of the sharing of hospitality. But we also use conversation. And so while Sarah was busy doing the cooking and making the bread and all of this other kinds of stuff, Abraham spent his time talking to the guests. Well, among other things, that was the only way. They didn't have Twitter, so in order to find out what was going on, they had to talk to the people they met. You know, they said, oh, what have you heard from Egypt? Is their army on waging war again? What's going on? Have you heard anything about my old home down there in Sumer? Are they still having a drought? Well, you know, that's why Abraham left his home territory, because things were getting fairly rough. The community was dissolving. And guess what the culprit was? Global warming. Can you believe it? Things were changing at the time very rapidly, and they could no longer raise enough food in what had been for thousands of years one of the high points of civilization on Earth. So Abraham wants to know what's going on. Have you heard anything of my relatives that are still back there? What else do you know? You know, what's going on? What's the price of wheat? Wherever, you know? So they would have spent all this time exchanging information, and obviously other people would have stopped by wherever it was, and so whatever Abraham knew and learned, he would pass on to them, and that sense of hospitality would be what really made a lot of the social fabric work. Well, we see a lot of the same thing with Martha and Mary. So Mary is, you know, fixing brownies and coffee and whatever else they were making at the time, and getting the things ready. And Mary is doing the conversation, spending time with Jesus. Now, I think we get a little bit of the wrong attitude in this sometimes, that, well, Martha shouldn't have been doing the cooking. No, that's not the problem. You know, Jesus appreciated both. Each have their role. And the problem was that Martha was indignant that Mary wasn't doing what she was doing. You know, tell her she should be more like me. And I think that's what set Jesus off. You know, said, no, Martha is doing her thing. And it's probably even better than what you're doing. And, okay, you know, he puts the record straight there. Not saying that he didn't like Martha's cookies. Not saying that, but he appreciated the fact that hospitality involved also the personal time people spent together. Well, considering hospitality is such a critical part of the social order and of these people, we have to say, well, what's our nature of hospitality today? Well, just talk about, we do our things, you know, you bring a hot dish to the funeral, or you sit down and you talk, and you go to the car to say goodbye. You know, you wonder how far Abraham walked with them before he went back to his house as they were talking and leaving. But there are other things. You know, it's not just doing something physical like Martha, but it's engaging somehow in our personal time and sharing, sitting down with someone to talk. A perfect example would be going to visit someone in the nursing home. It doesn't have to be terribly long, but the fact that we go there, do some, that's hospitality, that they are, we are able to share that kind of a thing. Hospitality usually works both ways. If somebody refused to offer hospitality to somebody in this situation, they were considered very rude and nasty. But the same thing is if someone offered you hospitality and you said, no, I can't stay, without having explained ahead of time, really good example of what's going on, that was considered rude too. You know, so when someone offers you hospitality, we have kind of an obligation really to say, okay, yeah, I'll spend some time with you. Maybe it doesn't have to be 5 hours, but then again, sometimes it turns that way. You know, I love the stories of the neighbors who had mailboxes right next to each other, and when they get to mail, if they'd meet at 11 o'clock in the morning and 4 o'clock in the afternoon, they'd be still talking. Okay, well, that's a sense of hospitality, as long as you can, and it doesn't obstruct anything else. But that's something we really need to be more attentive to. Now, in our world today, we have another issue. For Israel, hospitality, one of the big things in the Old Testament says that do not oppress the alien and the foreigner in your midst. You once were aliens and foreigners in the land of Egypt, you know what it's like, so you need to be more welcoming of those people who are here with you. So that raises up again our whole question of immigration, what's going on, and the big mess we find ourselves in. It's hard to just point fingers at one person. The issue is that basically since Eisenhower, our government has done nothing to try to work with immigration. We've just pretended it's not there. So all of a sudden now, when it's brought to our attention, even if in ways that we don't particularly like, we don't want to have to deal with it. You know, tell me who in Congress has actually done anything to deal with it. They gripe and 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 they gripe. Not a single proposal has come forward to say this would be a better idea. What should we do? You know, so we're really stuck in that mess. And that's something we really need to think about and to pray for, because hospitality, welcoming strangers, is a part of what our general attitude should be. You know, we sometimes pick on very small things that we can do, and we complain, oh, this is my big fault, is I didn't say my prayers this morning. Okay, but we don't look at the things like hospitality and to say, I was very rude to the neighbors who moved in because I didn't like their skin color. We consider that as being something wrong. It's far more worse than some of the other things that we would do. Our prejudices, our language, the things that come out, we need to look at that carefully and to say, how can we be more welcoming? Well, we need to be cautious about some things, I suppose. You know, in the very beginning, Benedictines, with St. Benedict, were known for hospitality. They very often would have a guest house where travelers were welcome to stay. Well, but you know, people are people. So eventually most of those places had to have a hard and fixed rule with a sign on the door, 3 days. That's the limit, whatever it was. We have to set a boundary. It's like Boswell. Boswell was an English, kind of a humorist and writer, but he wrote that both fish and guests stink after 3 days. So, you know, that's a principle. We welcome, but then we don't take advantage either. So we have to figure out how do we welcome the people that are coming to us and here with us. It's not the same as it was in 1820 when some of our grandparents and great-grandparents came, but still some of the principles are still the same. How do we make this thing work? It's going to be difficult, but we really need to think about it. And we're not going to do it in just a few flash Twitter comments. You know, Abraham and his strangers sat down and talked for 5 hours. If we have problems to work out, how long do we have to sit and talk to figure out how we're going to deal with these really important issues? And hospitality really is a critical and important issue of our Christian life. Maybe from Minnesota we have a bit of a head start, but we need to look very seriously. How do we welcome and make comfortable in our midst strangers like the angels? You know, that's where Dorothy Day got her comment from when she was running her facilities. Often she was told, but you can't be opening your door to just everybody. You know, somebody, you're going to get a bad person in there. And Dorothy said, but you know, by welcoming strangers, people have entertained angels. I think in some ways when we slam the door in people's faces, we are turning down God's presence in our midst. So we have all these good examples of hospitality that tell us this is fairly important for our life. We really need to think seriously about that. How do we welcome neighbors, friends, and strangers? We will recite the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty.
From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Trusting God's goodness and mercy, we bring our prayers. We ask that he would show us his light and his guidance for all that we do.
For Christians everywhere, that we reach out to strangers and welcome them with the love of Christ, we pray.
Hear our prayer.
For peace in the places of the world where there is conflict, and the ability to accept our differences and rejoice in the diversity of our gifts, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For love within our families, for generosity, gentleness, kindness, patience, and all that is needed for people to live together in peace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the ability to see each person as a child of God, especially those we find difficult to love, those who threaten us, or those who do not return our love, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, remembering Wayne, Dell, and Lucy Zimmerman, and Colleen Lindstrom, may they rest in the arms of our loving God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our community in need of prayer, that we hold them in God's light and bring his love to them, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, look with kindness on your people as we call to you. Help us each day to follow your way, open our eyes, that we might see the path you reveal to us. We make this prayer in the name of Jesus, for he is Lord forever and ever. Amen.
Our song for the preparation of the gifts will be number 437 in your maroon pew hymnal, or on the screen, number 437, O God, You Search Me.
God of my present, my past, and future too. Although your spirit is upon me, still I search for shelter from your light. There is nowhere on earth I can escape you. Even the darkness is radiant in your sight.
For you created me and shaped me, gave me life within my mother's womb. For the Safe in your hands, all creation is made new.
Pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord God, we pray that you would accept these offerings, which we bring from the abundance of your gifts to us, so that by the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries would sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal happiness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift
them. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by his passion, Christ accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, and summoning us to the glory by which we are now a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people set apart to be your own, that we might proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we proclaim.
Holy,
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 Lord God of hosts, heaven. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts by sending down your Spirit upon them, so that they would become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
This
This is the mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until you come again.
And so we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, giving thanks that you have counted us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. We pray that as we share in the body and blood of Christ, we would be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, so that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we would merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and would praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant peace in our days, so that by the help of your mercy we would always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. You who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share with one another some sign of Christ's peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away
the sins. Mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world.
Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the wedding feast of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ.
Our communion song is You Are Near, number 434 in the Maroon Pew hymnal, or on the screens, number 434, You Are Near. Oh Lord, I know you are near, standing always at my side. You guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting. Lord, you have searched my heart, and you know when I sit and when I stand. Your hand is upon me, protecting me from death, keeping me from harm.
Okay, where should I go?
Oh Lord, I know you are near, standing always at my side. You guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting.
Body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Where can I run from your love? If I climb to the heavens, you are there. If I fly to the sunrise or sail beyond the sea, still I'd find you there.
The body of Christ.
Oh Lord, I know you are near.
The body of Christ.
Standing always at my side.
The body of Christ.
You guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting. You know my heart and its ways. You who formed me before I was born. In the secret of darkness, before I saw the sun, in my mother's womb. Oh Lord, I know you are near.
The body of Christ.
Standing always at my side.
The body of Christ.
You guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Marvelous to me are your works. How profound are your thoughts, my Lord. Even if I could count them, they number as the stars. You would still be there.
The body of Christ.
Oh Lord, I know you are near, standing always at my side. You guard me
from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting.
The body of Christ.
Let us continue singing number 356, I Am the Living Bread.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
See this bread, take and eat and live in me. See this cup, take and drink, remember me.
Body of Christ.
I am the living bread, come down from heaven. All who eat my flesh Christ. And drink my blood
Body of Christ.
Will live forever. See this bread, take and eat and live in me.
Body of Christ.
See this cup, take and drink, Christ. Remember me.
Body of Christ.
I am the living bread. You shall not hunger if you believe in me. You shall not thirst. But live forever. See this bread, take and eat and live in me. See this cup, take and drink, remember me.
Anything we need to announce?
Nope.
Okay. Keep Father Steve in mind that he has a wonderful vacation and that he gets back safely. Let us pray. Lord God, we have received your divine sacrament, which is the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, would lead us to salvation. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
And let us go forth singing number 499, Go Make a Difference, number 499.
Go make a difference. We can make a
difference. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference. We can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world.
We are the salt of the earth, called to let the people see the love of God in you and me. We are the light of the world, not to be hidden but be seen. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference. We can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference. We can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world.
We are the hands of Christ, reaching out to those in need. The face of God for all to see. We are the spirit of hope. We are the voice of peace. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference. We can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference. We can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. So let your love shine on. Let it shine for all to see. Go make a difference in the world. And the Spirit of Christ will be with us as we go home.
Go make a difference
in the world. Go make a difference. We can make a difference. Go make a difference in the world. Go make a difference. We can make a difference.
Go make a difference in the world.